but they now are back in pursuit. And, of course, they can back off with the Kansas City, Missouri police helicopter on the scene. Now, high rates of speed, apparently. At one point, this down 152 Highway, Green Hills Road as well. And you'll have to excuse me if we sound distracted on occasion as we are up in the airspace for the International Airport, and we will have to occasionally talk to them as well as coordinate with other aircraft flying here, including the Kansas City, Missouri Police Department. Now, the this red Jeep, you'll see I-29. We'll pull back a little bit. I-29 right there just to the west of this. So we're just to the east of I-29 coming down towards Northwest 64th Street. This driver has been very erratic in his or her behavior. We're not sure the gender of the driver, but you can see now there is no police car in pursuit. Now we're coming up to 64th Street. They're headed southbound, getting ready to turn, we believe, onto 64th, and it looks like it will be a turn in our direction. We are just a little bit to the east of this. Kansas City, Missouri police helicopter way down low on top of this pursuit. We are now eastbound on Northwest 64th Street, and nope, now we've turned into an apartment complex. Right now, they have to know that there is no one behind them, but if they are looking right on this. Open it up, Blake. Yeah, I got him. I lost him. Okay, I can talk. All right, we do have police officers now closing in, and I would not be surprised to see if they may have him trapped here. In fact, all the entrances and exits to this apartment complex are now blocked. Kansas City, Missouri police helicopter on the scene now coming, wow, through a grassy area back over a sidewalk and back through the median again and back into residential areas. And that is the scary part of this pursuit right now, as typically we see these on some of the major thoroughfares, some of the interstates and freeways, but not this time. This appears to be a situation where it is a very dangerous situation, knowing that we are in residential areas. As you said, the weather is nice. Could be kids out. Now there's coming around a corner. There's a car opposing, and there's a parked car there. A narrow squeeze between that car and the car that was headed eastbound. We are back westbound now, back towards I-29. And again, the Kansas City, Missouri police helicopter is overhead, and no fewer than five police patrol cars now in pursuit. Back another right turn northbound. It looks like another turn to the right coming up here. Again, the Kansas City, Missouri police helicopter calling this out to the officers who are following. Boy, I almost wonder if they're considering breaking this off since it is in a residential area. Now, we're looking around, scanning to see if there are any kids up in these neighborhoods ahead of this car that is now back southbound. Very windy roads here just to the north and east of the intersection, the interchange of I-29 and Northwest 64th Street. We're still within probably a half mile of that. Back in between houses here, trying to cut through and kind of trapped now with a lot of fences here. Well, it looks like, I don't know if they made it through. Was that a fence they went through? Maybe trying to go through another one. And this might be the end of it. It looks like now they are tied up with this fence. Oh, moving again. And it looks like moving around, if I'm not mistaken, over to through another yard. And now they're at the end of a cul-de-sac. Back into another yard, breaking through more fences. Boy, a lot of damage being inflicted by this pursuit right now. And the person, this suspect, who is just not only blowing through yards, but fences. And stand by. We're okay, Chopper 9. We are probably going to be pretty much in this position for a little bit. And we'll let you know when we're clear. All right, that was the International Tower. And now it looks like the right front tire may be gone. Kansas City, Missouri police helicopter remains overhead. You can see patrol cars in pursuit, still going into yards between houses and onto another side street. Now in a cul-de-sac, they're going to have to, well, it looks like they're going to drive between a couple of houses here, maybe trying to get back on to Northwest 64th Street. And there they are, back onto 64th. This just to the east of I-29, now turning westbound along I-29. This is a red light coming up to this intersection. A lot of cars driving through. And what did you say, Blake? Smoke coming from the vehicle, could be from the tire, could be from the engine. And now it looks like we're going to proceed southbound along I-29. Yeah, boy, it looks like the engine of this vehicle is making smoke now again. And as you can see, a piece of wood in the windshield of this vehicle. So now we are southbound along I-29, showing about 40 or 45 miles an hour over the ground, and they are gaining on us and passing us now with police in pursuit. We are southbound I-29. The next major interchange will be I-635, and you can see police are in trail. We have at least two police cars now, just two patrol cars in trail of this vehicle. They are gaining on us, and we're showing about 70 miles an hour, 75 over the ground. Blake, let's go ahead, pull back, show the police presence here. One patrol car now, just one patrol car. Nope, I'll take that back. We have two patrol cars in pursuit. Moving over to the right side of the road, you wonder if they're having problems now as far as speed is concerned, and certainly controllability too, as we do believe at least one of the tires is out. Not by spike strips, by going through a couple of chain link fences and a couple of wood fences through those residential areas. We're continuing southbound now at the split. The left lanes will continue southbound on I-29. The right lanes will take you down 635, and it looks like that's where he's going. Southbound 635. They have it blocked up ahead here. It looks like police are on the scene, maybe with spike strips out. Police blocking traffic. Now the traffic is going to stop this vehicle, but I think they're going to be able to get between a couple of cars, and he did. Don't know if he made any contact there, but they got a spike strip out there. So now it looks like we may be seeing this vehicle even more disabled than it is. And now the left tire is out as well. We know the right front tire is out. We're looking down the highway, and we are seeing that there are police down here as we approach 9 Highway and International Tower. Chopper 9 is clear of Class B. And we'll get a little housework then. Okay, and they are continuing southbound at by 9 Highway, and there is perhaps more spike strips, trying to avoid those onto, and that was a Chopper 9 clear of the Class B as well. You can stand by, and we're talking to the International Tower, and we're going to have to do some switching of frequencies. All right, Chopper 9, appreciate that. Thanks for the help. All right, we are continuing southbound on 635 here, and you can see now crossing over southbound in the northbound lanes, crossing over between this, a very dangerous situation. Now, people who are northbound can see the police, I'm sure, southbound, but now we are on the shoulder of the road, and those who are a little bit further down the road are not going to know. Downtown Tower, Chopper 9 is with you here at 1.5. We're talking to the other guys. All right, we are southbound on the left shoulder of the northbound lanes. There's the off-ramp that takes you to 9 Highway, and traffic is relatively heavy here. We're right in the heart of rush hour. Not as heavy as it could be on some of the other highways. Still on the shoulder of the road, partially in that far left lane, and still southbound. So we are now southbound, opposing traffic in the northbound lanes of 635. Looks like maybe they're going to try and cut over here onto the Fairfax Bridge. Nope, just continuing southbound. Unbelievable how reckless this driver is right now. I mean, no regard for anybody. As we were talking about the residential areas they were going through, and as well as the, another close call, car off the road there, as well as high speeds on some of the... Okay, what are we doing here? Okay, thank you. Yeah, we were trying to figure out exactly what we wanted to do with that technical issue. Now we are continuing southbound this Horizon Parkway, I believe, that we just crossed over. We're approaching now the Missouri River. Look how slow northbound traffic is, but still, okay, they have police that are down the in the southbound lanes. It looks like they are warning traffic now to slow down for this vehicle across lanes of traffic. It looks like they're probably going to try a U-turn here, maybe down Horizon Parkway, and nope, they're going to continue southbound in the northbound lanes of 630. You can see on the left shoulder, police were down the highway here. We thought maybe warning those who were northbound of this vehicle that was. We're going south. Yeah, and we are for master control there in live ops. We're headed southbound, so you're going to be going down the compass there a little bit. It is southbound still here at 635. Looks like now going to exit the off-ramp that would normally be from, nope, they're not, as a matter of fact. Continuing southbound on 635. Thought they were going to get on 5 Highway there. Police are in pursuit on the right shoulder of the northbound lanes of 635 as well. There's one of the 5 Highway ramps, as you can see. Still at a relatively high rate of speed. I'd have to say maybe 50 miles an hour at the most now, as this vehicle may be having controllability problems. We know spike sticks were out. As you said, we do have that piece of wood in the windshield. We know the right front tire was flat. Now we think perhaps the left front tire as well, but a very dangerous situation as folks are northbound on 635 now as we're approaching Leavenworth Road. There's a car on the side of the road that was threading the needle as well as northbound traffic. Thankfully, no one in the far right lane as they went around that vehicle, and now police officers are being held up by that stalled car on the right shoulder. Exiting now, actually the on-ramp that would normally be from Leavenworth Road, almost ahead on there, to northbound 635, but instead continuing southbound now along, well, they were on Leavenworth Road going on another side street, and I'm going to lose them behind me here. It looks like we are at about 35th Street, just south of Leavenworth Road, coming up to Kimball now, and a ton of side streets. Going to have to circle back around to the left so I can get a visual out the window again, but it looks like they're going back over to a 635. Police now very close in pursuit here, and we are going to make a hard right turn and hope that we don't lose the signal here as we do that. Now it appears as though, well, he bypassed the ramp that would have taken him from the Leavenworth Road to southbound 635, and I believe this is going to be 38th Street, where we are now southbound on 38th Street, coming out of KCK with police in pursuit. At least they are close now. The Kansas City, Missouri Police Department helicopter has crossed state lines and remains close in on this pursuit. And now we're seeing Kansas City, Kansas police up here, Parallel Parkway. They are blocking roads there. So I imagine as soon as the driver here sees that presence, we may see a turn onto one of these side streets. I can't imagine they're going to try and blow through what looks like 3 or 4 police cars at the intersection now of 38th and Parallel Parkway. I want to confirm, yes, that is 38th Street that we are looking at right now. This paralleling 635 that is just off to the west of us, and we are continuing southbound on 38th. And it looks like, yes, as I thought, they were going to try and get away from the police that were waiting there at Parallel Parkway. We're going to come back around to the left, and we're going to clear traffic up in the air here. And we are continuing now in a left turn, going no more roads, going through yards. And I am going to make a turn around here, too. Police remain on 38th Street as they are kind of staging there, wondering and trying to figure out, of course, what this guy's next move is going to be. Seems as though the vehicle is really slowing down here. Maybe an indication that, and we would imagine with the spike strips that were out, that we may be seeing some problem with the vehicle. Very close now. Kansas City, Kansas police in pursuit. You know, different jurisdictions have different rules of engagement as far as what they can do with these vehicles, and perhaps that vehicle trying to get in position to do the pit maneuver, which would swing them around. Now, It does appear that the car is slowing down. Whether or not that is by design or we're seeing some sort of a problem with the vehicle is unknown now. But Kansas City, Kansas police officer right on this suspect's tail as they continue now northbound at about 36th Street, although it seems at a much slower speed than we saw just a little while ago. The pit maneuver, of course, is where they get to the rear of the vehicle, knock into one of the back fenders, and try and spin them around and turn them the wrong way, momentarily disable the car, and then they can perhaps trap them in that position. Continuing northbound, speeds are down now. We are coming back up to Leavenworth Road, or close to it, and it will be really, I'm trying to think of where they might go from here. Could certainly be down Leavenworth Road. There is relatively heavy traffic now coming east and westbound along Leavenworth Road here at 36th Street. In fact, there's a truck just coming on. Truck just coming on to. Yeah, but at a very slow speed now, in comparison to what we saw earlier, this could be they just dumped something else out of the vehicle. We had heard that they were ejecting things from the vehicle earlier as well at a very slow speed now, so we may see this finally coming to an end. Black smoke now pouring from the vehicle, an indication perhaps of some serious engine trouble, as you might imagine. And yeah, we think this vehicle probably on its last legs. Now, the question is, they've gone off into some wooded area here, and it looks like there they may bail. And there's one. We'll try and stay with that person, Blake, if you would. You might want to pull back a little, lighten it up. There you go. There is the Kansas City, Missouri police helicopter. There are so many police officers out here, and this is a very very small wooded area. I can't imagine they're going to get too far. In fact, police still in pursuit. Are you able to see him, Blake? There we go. Go ahead and pull back if you happen to know where he might be in there. Going into a building right there. And go to your filter number 2, if you could, Blake. Open that up for us. Okay, stand by. There we go. There we go. Yeah. Gain. And we're coming back around here to see if, of course, it's gotten a little darker on us here. And if you can hit your gain there, Blake, that will help. If you know where that is. There we go. Okay, now we're getting a little more light on the subject. Imagine now police are in this building. And again, if the passenger got out, police were right there. And the passenger may not have had anything to do with this and may not have been trying to evade police at all. But we do know police, as you said, in that building. We see them outside the building. And we don't know whether or not anyone is inside in custody. It looks like police, at least from this vantage point, may still be looking. And we will probably kind of park it right here and see if we can see what transpires next. See if, a lot of police behind that building right now. But we do not see a suspect. In fact, it looks like they may have the building surrounded. Maybe something in the back of the are they at gunpoint there, Blake? We're at Leavenworth Road, the corner of Leavenworth Road and about 27th Street or so. Actually, it's Brown Road and 27th. Oh, they've got him on the roof of the building right now. Hands up. They've got him at gunpoint. Now it is police to get, go ahead and zoom right in on that, Blake. Let's take a look at this suspect. You can see he is at gunpoint. He does have his arms extended. No place to hide here. Look at the damage to that building. Looks like it may actually have been burned out or something. Now, how the suspect or how they get this suspect in custody is going to be interesting. He may be coming over the side of the building. And we'll come around here real quick if we can. Is he still on the building? Still on the building. Okay. Okay. Look at the number of police officers with guns drawn now. And obviously they want this guy who put a bunch of people, innumerable people in jeopardy in this chase with the incredible recklessness that we saw driving through those neighborhoods up north of the river, even here in Kansas City, Kansas. Now the question is, police getting on the roof. It does look like that building is burned out. I wonder myself how he got up there, but he has elected to surrender, and now we will keep it right here while police get him in custody. That is an eventuality here. Now they just need to figure out how they're going to do that. So I guess you would say that the suspect is in modified custody. They don't have their hands on him yet, but he's not going anywhere. I think that's pretty obvious. We'll let you guys take it down there. You get Iris down here? Yeah. No, not Iris, not... Okay, all right. I can talk some more if you want me to. You know, something unusual about this chase, and we see very short duration chases relatively frequently, but one of this duration and one that covered this much real estate, both sides of the state line for, well, I'm trying to think of how far it would be just from KCI on down here to KCK, where we're just barely south of 635 and right at Leavenworth Road. I think they call it Brown Road at this location. You think of all the real estate that was covered with that, and how many miles, and then how long this lasted. Came in before the 5 o'clock news ended, and it was well underway then, and we picked it up at about 5:25, 5:30, and that is when, of course, we saw it head southbound down 635, and probably the scariest moments were when this driver was on the left shoulder and then the right shoulder going southbound in the northbound lanes of 635. So thankfully, this guy is off the road right now, on the roof. What a strange ending to this chase. We have seen, and we're just getting word now from the news desk, that the fire department is on the way to get him down. So they're going to bring him down, bring in a hook and ladder, and get him down that way. But unbelievable to see how much this driver would do to evade police and just continue. Of course, we know there was a passenger in the car. We have not seen that person, but it did not appear as though the passenger was trying to run from police as they bailed from the car here after they went off-roading again into that wooded area here in KCK close to Leavenworth Road and 30, about 30th Street or so. So that is how it remains, although now he is moving. Perhaps he is, I don't believe he's injured, but he appears to be now prone on the ledge of this building. You can see it's burned out to the right. This, I believe, a two-story building. No, it's a one-story building. I believe it's a one-story building, but you can see he is prone now, and perhaps they've just told him to, well, for all intents and purposes, relax until the fire department gets here, and they are on the scene. We'll pull back, show you that the Kansas City, Kansas Fire Department has arrived. Just now starting to get some of that light rain, too, here. It's getting a little bit of a sprinkle. I don't think it's enough to wet down the roads, but it could be getting kind of slippery on that ledge here pretty soon, too. Probably the last thing they want to see is for this guy to get injured after they've gone through all this. And want to get him in custody safely so that he can go through the due process and answer to all of the violations that I'm sure stacked up as this chase continued. So that is the scene. The fire department is on the scene now, and we're anticipating, I guess, a suspect recovery here any minute now. We'll send it back down to you guys. Way far, oh, I don't know. He's above me. Got him. Well, suspect officially in custody down the ladder from this burned-out building in Kansas City, Kansas. He is on the ground. We'll see if there's any resisting of arrest, and I imagine by this point he has pretty much figured out that that would be futile. What about his feet, are you telling me?